Sorry about that. It cut off before I was finished. Okay, so once you have your project finished, you're ready, and you've done a little research on Romero, you're ready to break up your project into some different sections, okay? I went ahead and drew mine with pencil first, so I decided where I wanted to divide up my shapes. And the purpose for dividing it up is so it gives you opportunities to put different patterns and different colors and different sections of your sculpture. So you can see, I went ahead and traced over my sections with Sharpie so that you could see them a little bit better. But if you want to just stick with pencil at this point, that's totally fine. So after you have it divided out into your sections, then you're ready to start painting. So again, make sure you look at Romero's artwork. Look for inspiration of the colors that he uses. Look for inspiration on the patterns that he uses. You want your project to be filled with bright colors, a variety of colors, and a variety of different patterns. Your patterns do not have to be complicated. Just a combination of stripes and polka dots and squares and any kind of designs that you want to add into it. So typically he has a background color with some kind of accent pattern on top of it. A lot of times he would use several different sizes and different directions of stripes within the same artwork. So you can get a lot of variety just with using stripes and a different combination of colors. So once you have it all divided, start to paint your sections. Now remember, as always, make sure that when you're painting patterns on top of other colors, make sure that that paint is really nice and dry before you start to paint on top of it. Otherwise, you'll get some mixing of colors that can turn out kind of muddy and brown. Also, if you're painting next to a color, make sure it's dry as well. So for this, I went ahead and painted all of my hot pink stripes, let it sit for a little bit to dry, and then came in with kind of that limey green color. On my orange section up here, I painted it orange first, let that dry, and then painted my dots on top of that. If you're painting a darker pattern on top of a lighter color, typically you can just paint the whole background and then add your color, darker color on top of that. If you have a dark background though, and you're adding a light pattern on top of it, you need to make sure that you let it dry really well. And if it's not showing up on top of it, go ahead and paint your patterns in white, let that dry, and then paint your color on top of it. For instance, if I had a dark blue section here and I was painting some yellow hearts on top of it, I would paint it blue, let it dry, paint my hearts with white, let it dry, and then add my yellow on top of that. That's one method. Another method is you can actually draw your shapes and paint around them, leaving a nice white background to paint your lighter color on top of. So whichever works better for your pattern that you're working on. Okay, so that is it. Once you have this all painted with your patterns, the last step then is to use black paint and accent your sections. So where I have my lines drawn with Sharpie, after I've painted all my background sections, then I would come in with black and do a nice thin outline over the lines that I have drawn here, just so that they really pop and stand out, okay? I can't wait to see what you guys come up with and how they turn out. So be sure to post your pictures on our Facebook group or email them to me or text them to me and I can post them on there. I can't wait to see your projects. I miss you guys and cannot wait to be back together again in the fall for the next school year. Holler if you have any questions, and I'd love to hear from you and love to see your work. Talk to you later. Bye.